Turning now to Weather Authority Chief Meteorologist Dann Cianca, tracking things outdoors for us. Hey, Max.
Yeah, I had to chase a coyote away from my little doggo a couple weeks ago, four-door. Well, not really. I mean, it was kind of following us, and I decided to approach it to make it go away. It did. Listen to me. I said, go away. And it listened. Now, I've been trying to say that to the clouds for a while, but there you go. They're still here. Go away, clouds. We want some sunshine on the coast. This is a live view from the Pack Rep webcam in Carmel. And as you can guess it, we're stuck in the clouds once again. We did get a little clearing in Santa Cruz today. There's some sunshine for you. The low clouds thickening on the south and east sides of the bay as the sun headed down. Inland areas, well, you woke up to plenty of low clouds, and we've had just this little bubble of cloud cover over southern San Benito County. It looks like right in between San Benito Mountain, the highest point in San Benito County, and Santa Rita Peak. We found it. Take a look at it. This is a webcam from Henrietta Peak near Hollister. We found that cloud. There's your inland cloud. Normally I would put clouds plural, but we only have one of them, so there you go. We have a couple ones over the mountains inland. Looking at the wind right now, seeing some gusts closing in on 20 miles per hour. A little breezy as that cool air continues to push into our inland valleys. It's still cooler than normal for this time of year for both our coast and inland areas. And right now around the bay, the 60s, a few spots inland in the 70s and 80s, and just outside our viewing area in Kalinga, we are at 90 degrees. So we look for the rest of the evening. You can expect a cooler one under mostly cloudy skies. Your sunset tonight, 8:19 p.m. Those low clouds will be on the increase, thickening up once again around the bay. Now let us zoom all the way in from space into the earth and check in on that area of low pressure I was talking about yesterday. It's now over the Great Basin, showers, thunderstorms up into the deserts of western Colorado and Utah. Thunderstorms. My dad just said they got a thunderstorm in Butte, Montana today. So that activity all moving away. We're still in between these two areas of high pressure, and the thing is, they're just not going to be close enough together to really warm us up. We're seeing persistent troughing on the coast, this lowered area of lines here into next week. So even though I was a little bit warmer in my forecast yesterday, I'm going to keep us cooler through the weekend. Highs should be below normal, both on the coast and inland, for at least the next 4 or 5 days. And that's going to mean the continuation of the daily cycle of low clouds. We'll wake up to them in the morning with patchy sunshine in the afternoon, and then they'll return in the evening once again, and that means temperatures again slightly cool for this time of year. Let's go through them. Santa Cruz, your Friday high, 70 degrees, 80 in Boulder Creek, 67 in Capitola, east shore of the bay in the 60s, 70 in Salinas, 78 in Hollister, 80s into the Santa Clara Valley. All of the Monterey Peninsula tomorrow remaining in the 60s, Monterey topping out only at 65, which is cool for this time of year. And southward we go, the Salinas Valley in the 70s to low 80s, and a few spots in the far south, and up at the Pinnacles, reaching the 90s. We'll be pleasant in Carmel Valley and Big Sur with mid-70s. Now, as I mentioned, not a lot of warmth in the forecast. Maybe by mid to late next week as high pressure strengthens across the region. Otherwise, at or below normal high temperatures, we should be at 69 this time of year on the coast, and the daily cycle of low clouds, I just see it continuing. No changes in the next 7 days or so. Inland areas, well, your normal high this time of year around 86, so, you know, we're anywhere from 3 to 5, 6 degrees below that for the next 4, 5, 6 days under mostly sunny skies. You'll have morning low clouds in the valleys, afternoon sun with wind, and then looks like that high pressure ridge will strengthen late next week, which will bring some warmth. And right now, no rain anywhere near us in the forecast outside of a little bit of coastal drizzle here and there.